Hello everyone! Hello grade 12 students! It's me again, Ma'am Terebena, your guidance counselor. Kumusta po kayo? So today we are going to start with our discussion of your homeroom guidance module 3. Okay, so I hope nahanda na tayong lahat. So kumuha na po ng ballpen at ng papel at tayo ay magsisimula na. Now if you don't have yet a copy of this module, you can download first the copy of this module. I am going to put the link below and we are now going to start. Okay, so let's go. Okay, so for your module 3, the title is Thinking Aloud My Decisions. Okay, so again, the title is Thinking Aloud My Decisions. And same thing with module 1 and 2. You can see on page 2, the Intellectual Property Code of the Philippines and the Development Team. Now, on page 3, still, you can see there a message for your parents. This is the gabay sa magulang or tagapag-alaga. Isinulat ang module na ito bilang gabay ng inyong anak upang malinang ang kanyang aspetong personal at sosyal. Nakadisenyo ito para sa distance learning o alternatibong pamamaraan ng pagkatuto na hindi nangangailangan ng physical na presensya sa paaralan bilang tugon sa direktiba ng pagkansela ng face-to-face class dulot ng pandemyang COVID-19. Maaaring may mga pagkakataon na hingin na mag-aaral ang inyong patnubay sa pagsunod sa mga tagubilin at pagsagot sa mga tanong sa bawat bahagi ng mga gawain. Hinihiling ng kagawaran ng inyong suporta upang matagumpay niyang maisakatuparan ang mga gawain. Makatutulong ang araling ito upang hubugin ang kanyang kabutihan na tanggapin ang pagkakaiba-iba ng bawat tao sa katangian, kakayahan, damdamin at pananaw. Tiyakin na sasagutin niya ang bawat bahagi ng module ng tapat. Siguraduhin maipapasa niya ang kanyang sagutang papel sa petsa at oras na itinakda ng kanyang gurong tagapayo. Again, you have to let your parents read this part or you can read this to your parents. Okay? Now, for the introductory message for the learner, decision-making is a key concept in your development. You can be reflective or impulsive in doing it. Thus, you tend to make well-thought-out or rushed decisions without considering first its implications. In the process of the decision-making, it is important that your values are intact and that it should not be compromised. As we enter the new normal, most of you are feeling empty periods on a daily basis using mobile communication, text messaging, and chat sites in expanded personal and virtual networks. The pandemic you are in may affect your character to cope with the situations. In these trying times, you have to follow the given protocols and ethical standards that make us dignified humans capable of adapting to change and morally upright in thinking and doing. Now, this module will help you realize that as a human being, you may be capable to commit right and wrong decisions or decisions. It will introduce to you some learning tasks that will help you depict some tendencies in making right and wrong decisions or becoming indecisive and on how you can resolve this by carefully considering some factors that may affect your decision making. Ayan, napakaganda na magiging discussion natin ngayong araw, my dear grade 12 students, because we are going to talk about decision making. Now, for this learning module, we have here 6 interactive tasks. We have again, let's try this. Let's explore this. Keep in mind, you can do it. What I have learned, share your thoughts and feelings. And make sure to read, think, follow, and enjoy every task that you are asked to do. Have fun, stay safe, and healthy. Okay, so again, the title of our module 3 is Thinking Aloud My Decisions. How do you think out loud? So we are going to know it later. Now, for our learning objectives, at the end of this module, you are expected to, number 1, identify the factors that affect the right and wrong actions or decisions. Number 2, recognize the tendencies of every individual to make right and wrong decisions or actions. And number 3, analyze situations that depict tendencies of making right and wrong decisions or actions. Now, this is good for week 3 and 4 of first quarter. Suggested total time allotment is 120 minutes and you will be needing clean sheet of paper and pen. Now for the introduction. So in the previous module, you learned how to accept others' individuality. Now let's have a recap. What is the title of our module 2? Okay, again, the title of our module 2 is Accepting the Individuality of Others. Ayan. So you even formulated and your personal policies or guidelines to uphold acceptance and respect of people's differences at all times. Diba? Binag-usapan natin that we are all different from each other, that we have to accept others' uniqueness and individuality. Now, in this module, you are up to another insightful learning episode. You will delve into the decision-making process. Remember that you are free to choose a course of action from among various alternatives. Diba? Malaya tayong pumili ng kahit na anumang bagay na gugustuhin natin from different alternatives. However, your choice has consequences, okay? And you are responsible for your own actions. Sa lahat ng actions natin, lagi yan may katapat na consequence, okay? And of course, we are always responsible of our own actions. Now, you will encounter some factors that may affect your sound decision-making like past experiences, biases, current situation or setup, and individual differences. Okay, so pag-aaralan din natin ang mga factors na maaaring makaapekto sa inyong paggawa ng inyong decision. Okay, so here, under Let's Try This, suggested time allotment is 20 minutes. Now, what you're going to do is you're going to read the story of Anton. Anton is a senior high school graduate. Then, answer the pros and questions on a separate sheet of paper. Now, let's have the story of Anton. Now, the title is Anton's Indecisiveness. Anton, who took up the general academic trend in senior high school, has a hard time deciding what course to enroll in college. He graduated with honors and has received his special citation. He is great in science and math, but he is also into arts and graphic designing. He was told by his parents to decide for his course since colleges are already closing admission and the school opening is approaching fast. He is spending night analyzing his options. Sometimes he barely sleeps over analyzing all considerations. There are also pressures from his friends for him to join them in the university where there are wide a variety of science course he can choose from. He also considers the suggestion of his teachers who see his potential in graphic designing and multimedia arts. Anton really wants to enroll in the most prestigious school to study the course that perfectly fits him. After thorough self-deliberation, he comes down to 2 schools and 4 courses. But this does not end his considerations. He still has more factors to visit. His family and friends are starting to worry if he could ever make a final decision. It has finally come one day when everything was in place. Anton finally decides to enroll. He hurries to the school of his choice, but he's an hour late. The enrollment has just closed for his first choice. To add in more to his regrets, his second chosen program has also reached the maximum number of students that it was closed days ago. Sad and full of regrets, Anton comes home thinking of the lost time, overthinking his options, and that is because he can just not make up his mind. So that was really a sad story for Anton, right? So let's try to answer the processing questions. You are going to write your answers on a sheet of paper. Number one, did you experience spending more time to make a decision that greatly affects you or your future just like Anton? Katulad din ba kayo ni Anton na nakaranas na napakaraming oras ang iginugugol ninyo sa paggawa ng isang desisyon na maaaring makaapekto sa iyo at sa iyong hinaharap or sa iyong future? So you are going to share your experience. So nakakalungkot ang nangyari kay Anton because he overthinked. He was not able to decide. So he spent a lot of time in thinking and he was not able to decide for his course in college, di ba? So kaya naman na masyado siya nag-overanalyze and he was not able to sleep because of overanalyzing, overthinking of things. Now, mayroon ba kayong ganong klaseng karanasan wherein nag-spend kayo or nag-gumugol kayo or nag-consume kayo na napakaraming oras sa paggawa namang lamang ng isang desisyon? So, share your experience. And number two, if you are in his situation, what would be your next move? Since Anton was not able to enroll in the school of his choice, now, on his second chosen program, again, he felt frustrated because already reached the maximum number of students, okay? And it was closed days ago. So, araw lang yung pagitan at nagsara na ang program or course na gusto ni Anton. Now, kung ikaw si Anton, ano ba ang iyong susunod na gagawin? And number three, what should you do so you won't face the same problem at that of Anton? Ano ba ang iyong gagawin para hindi ka matulad kay Anton? Okay, so the lesson here is very clear. Yes, in making a decision, it's really important that we really have to think of it very well. Okay, we have to think of it over and over again. But we also have to be conscious of the time and of course the consequences of our decisions. Now, probably masyado nang matagal ang iginugugol natin sa pag-iisip. Now, we are just thinking and not even thinking of the consequences of that particular action. Now, we are going to go deeper on that on the next part of this module. Now, under Let's Explore This, suggested time allotment is 15 minutes. The title is Agree or Disagree. On a separate sheet of paper, write agree or disagree on a given situations and read each statement carefully to make sure that it best matches your opinion. Okay, ano ba yung mga statement? You just have to write in your paper agree or disagree. Number one, I cannot tell my best friend's parents about his smoking and drinking tendencies because I will betray his trust. Okay, do you agree or disagree with that particular situation? Okay. And number two, I should consider the advice of my parents when it comes to choosing my course in college. Now, do you agree or disagree? Are you going to follow your parents? Now, number three, it is okay to take credit for others, people's work, as long as it serves a good purpose. Do you agree or disagree? Okay lang ba na mag-take credit ka sa gawa ng ibang tao as long as maganda naman ang purpose mo, maganda naman yung adhikain mo, or maganda yung intention mo? Okay. And number four, choosing a career that will employ easily is more practical than pursuing a passion that will take years before getting a good learning. Okay. So, do you agree or disagree? Okay? Mas gusto mo ba na pumili ng career na magkakaroon ka agad ng trabaho or mai-employ ka kaagad? And do you think that this is more, do you think na mas practical na pumili ng career na magkakaroon ka agad ng trabaho rather than pursuing a passion? Gusto mo nga, it will take time for you to get a good earning. Okay. And number five, the curriculum exit that you should choose after senior high school should best match the track and strand you are taking.
Okay, do you agree or disagree?
Now for the pros and questions, you're going to answer this on a sheet of paper. Number one, what are the factors that you considered in answering? Ano ba yung mga ikinonsider mo para masagutan ang mga katanungan na yan? Two, do your experiences at this time of pandemic change the way you decide on things? In what way? Okay, so ang mga experiences mo ba ngayong panahon ng pandemic ay binago ang paraan mo sa pag-decide or sa paggawa ng desisyon sa mga bagay-bagay? Sa anong paraan? In what way? Okay, under keep in mind, suggested time allotment is 25 minutes. So here, we are going to discuss this. So we make countless choices every day. From the very moment we opened our eyes in the morning up to the time we fall back to our beds, and our choices are neither right or nor wrong. So ang dami-dami natin ginagawang desisyon, from the very little up to the very big decision. Now, from kung ano ang isusuot mo sa araw na yun, what are you going to do on that particular day, what are you going to eat, all those small decisions are just examples of the kind of decision that we do every day. Now, di ba? According to Stephen J. Hayne, he is the author of the book Cultural Psychology, choice is something that is surely valued everywhere. However, the extent to which people value choices and exercise it is influenced by the context we are in. Sabi daw ni Stephen Hayne sa kanyang libro na Cultural Psychology, paka-importante na choice na mga ginagawa natin, di ba? Mga ginagawa nating mga choices is of course influenced by different factors. So more choices are available to individuals acting alone than to those who are part of interdependent group of people. However, the limits on their choices are likely not experienced as aversive when individuals share the same goals as their group. Okay. So, mas marami daw ang choices ng isang individual or isang tao na nag-a-act alone than those na part ng isang grupo ng mga tao. So, therefore, nalilimit ang mga choices ng mga tao na sama sa isang grupo. Okay? So, the limits on their choices are likely not experienced as aversive when individuals share the same goals as their group. So, for example, you choose not to attend classes because your peers invited you to join them outside the school during class hour, although you are aware of your responsibility in the school. So, ang phenomenon na yon I explained down ni Rolio May. Siya ay isang American psychologist who articulated that human beings are inseparable from their environment. A simultaneous relationship exists and evolving three models such as the following. Ano ba yung tatlong model na yon? We have the physical and physiological. We have the social environment of the people and the human being's relationship to their inner nature. So therefore, in this phenomenon, it is stated here that we are definitely influenced by our environment. We exist with our environment. Now, we are inseparable from our environment. Now, that's the reason why a simultaneous relationship exists. And ang tatlong model na ito, yung physical and physiological, social environment of the people, and human beings' relationship to their inner nature, ito yung mga simultaneous relationship na meron tayo, okay? Now, Ludwig Binswanger, he is an existential psychologist, explained that humans have complete freedom of choice or free will and are completely responsible for their own existence. So there was always the possibility of becoming something new or better because existence changes. Okay, so meron daw tayong free will or meron tayong kalayaan para mag-decide para sa ating sarili, and we are responsible of our own decision or of our own action. So we are completely responsible of our own existence. So may possibility na, of course, we change or we have this tendency or we have this capability to change for the better. Okay, so Napakaganda ng theory na ito ni Ludwig Binswanger. Now, how are we going to correct our mistakes from the past? Paano ba natin maitatama ang mga maling nagawa natin sa nakaraan? So, kailangan daw natin na palitan ang ating mindset. We have to change our mindset. So, change is always a choice. Ang mismo po kung ikaw ay magbabago. You need to realize that you can control your own behavior and need to make better choices. Diba? Walang ibang pwedeng kumontrol sa sarili mo kundi ikaw din. You need to realize that you can control your own behavior and need to make better choices. Things don't just happen. You can take much more effective control of your life through planning. So how are you going to control your life? So you have to plan very well. That is true planning. What are the strategies to promote change and foresee the possible wrong decisions and future actions? So ano ba yung mga pwede natin gawing strategy para ma-promote natin ang pagbabago or magbago tayo at malaman natin ang mga possible na mga posible na mali nating magagawa in the future, okay? According sa isang American psychologist na si Gerald Corey, first thing is to explore what your wants, needs, and perceptions are. Ano ba yung mga gusto mo? Ano ba yung kailangan mo? At ano ba yung mga perception mo? Now, try to recognize, define, and refine how you wish to meet your needs. And next, or second, you're going to focus on what you are doing at present and think of your future direction. Pag-isipan mo kung tama ba ang ginagawa mo sa present at ito ba ay makakatulong para sa mga plano mo in the future. Okay? And of course, you're going to take action by changing what you are doing and thinking. Now, after analyzing things, right, you are now going to decide and make way or do some action in order for your plans to be materialized. And of course, third is to make a self-evaluation. Okay, try to assess yourself. It is your responsibility to evaluate your own behavior. Now, ikaw mismo ang dapat na nakakaalam kung ang ginagawa mo ba ay akma para sa gusto mong maging balang araw or para sa mga future plans mo. And of course, lastly, you are going to formulate your action plan. Now, kailangan natin gumawa ng ating mga plano or action plan. Therefore, hindi lamang ito plano but we have to do something in order for our plan to be materialized. Now, creating and carrying out your plans enable you to gain more effective control over life. Now, if your plan does not work, devise a different plan. Your commitment is essential to carry out your plans. Now, what are the factors that affect our decisions? Ano nga ba ang nakaka-apekto talaga sa ating mga ginagawang desisyon? We act or decide based on different considerations and factors. And most especially, if the situations demand a very important decision, we need to carefully assess our choices and calculate the risk that we might face. Therefore, kailangan pala natin i-consider ang mga factors na babanggitin ko para mas maging effective ang ating magiging decision making. So therefore, kailangan daw na sa lahat ng sitwasyon, okay, napaka-importante i-assess natin ang ating mga choices and at the same time, we have to look at the risk that we might face. Tingnan natin kung ba yung magiging result. Ano kaya sa tingin mo ang magiging result ng decision na gagawin mo? Now, for number one, we have here the environment. The people around us, including the current setup, affect the way we see things. Okay? They can influence our beliefs, our perception, on the consequences of our action. Napaka-importante ng environment or ng ating kapaligiran sa paggawa natin ng desisyon. Kasama na dito ang mga tao na nakapaligid sa atin at yung ating current setup, okay? So, ito ay nakaka-apekto kung paano natin tinitingnan ang mga bagay-bagay, di ba? Nakaka-influence ito sa ating mga paniniwala at sa ating mga perception at ito ay syempre meron ding consequence. Ito ay nakaka-apekto din sa perception natin sa maaaring maging resulta ng ating mga ginagawa. Now, there are times that we intend to compare how they face a certain problem with the way we face it ourselves. So this is something that we need to get away from us. We are all different, including the situation we are in. So, and we have this tendency, of course, to compare, diba? To compare ourselves with others, to compare how we face a particular problem, okay? So, with the way we see it ourselves. Now, maaari na ikinukumpara mo or tinitingnan mo din ang nagiging ang decision ng iba, so ito ay nakaka-apekto din sa'yo. So, definitely, hindi daw ito magandang gawin natin because of course, we have different situations, we have different life also, right? Now, under experiences, our past encounter with people and the results of our decisions before mold how we act and decide today. Now, napakalaking bagay ng mga experiences natin sa paggawa natin ng desisyon. Na ang mga naging experience natin sa past ay isa sa mga nagdedetermine kung ano ang klase tayong magdesisyon sa mga panahong ito. Now, for instance, if you have proven that a certain person should not be trusted with your secrets, then you won't entrust him or her the confidential matters that you have. The same thing if you have tested action to be effective, like your study habits which led you to get high grades, then there is a great possibility to replicate such practice. Now, yung mga experiences natin daw kung ito, whether ito ay maganda or hindi maganda, ay ang nagsishape sa atin, nagsishape ng ating behavior nowadays. Okay? And number 3 is characteristics. We should also take into account the function of our culture, attitude, personality, beliefs, abilities, gender, health condition, and others in terms of our way of making a decision. Napakalaking bagay din ng ating mga personalidad, ang ating personal characteristics, okay? Yung mga katangian mo. Sama na dito ang iyong kultura, ang iyong ugali, ang personalidad mo, mga paniniwala mo, ang iyong abilidad, ang iyong gender, kung ikaw man ay babae o lalaki, and even your health condition. Ito ay nakakaapekto sa ating ginagawang desisyon. Now, we have to recognize that there are enabling and limiting aspects of your personal characteristics. For instance, in your culture, there may be a stigma on the role of a man and a woman. It is now up to you whether you want to live up to that expectation or not. You may want to look into what science tells about healthy and unhealthy practices. Now, therefore, our personal characteristics plays an important role in our decision-making process. And of course, number 4, we have here facts or data. It is a good practice to decide based on the merit of actual facts or data. Okay? Napaka-importante na ibabase natin ang decision natin sa mga existing na facts, okay? Or existing na mga information or data. It will definitely inform you on the exact scenario you are dealing with, and you can calculate how your decisions would impact the situation. For example, you need to decide your curriculum exit. You may check the number of schools where you can pursue whatever course you have planned to have. At the same time, you may look into the data on senior high school graduates who are employed after basic education and those that ventured into business. So therefore, kailangan din nating mag-research, kailangan din nating humanap ng mga evidences or ng mga facts in order for us to make a very good decision. Ito ang tinatawag nating informed decision. So when we have informed decision, therefore, you consider data in decision making. Now, number 5 is motivation. Our drive to achieve certain things influences our decisions. Sometimes, we need to let go of small things in order to attain greater things. Okay? So, for example, you slip away your opportunity to be with your friends on a Saturday because it's your schedule for college application interview. Now, your goal to be a college graduate is bigger than your desire to enjoy the company of your friends, so you opted to be at the interview. It has something to do with your personal drive. If you really would like a particular thing to happen, therefore, you are going to do all the best things that you can in order for you to make it possible. So, pag ginusto mo, talagang mangyayari yun, di ba? Sabi nga nila, Pag gusto, maraming paraan. Pag ayaw, maraming dahilan. Isa ito sa tinutukoy natin dito sa motivation. So, nasa sa'yo yan. Kung talagang gugustuhin mo, bakit hindi, di ba? So, it's up to you on how you are going to decide on things. Now, you have to think always of the consequences and of course, of the bigger picture. Titingnan natin kung ano ba yung gagawin natin. Ito ba ay akma pa rin sa mga plano natin or ito ba ay panandalian lamang at hindi makakatulong sa mga goals natin. So, that's what you're going to take into consideration. Now, your decisions will define the kind of choices you are taking. At the end of the day, you will be the one to face when whatever consequences this decision bring. Hence, your decision-making process is very important. If you are in doubt or confused about your choices, you may want to go someone who is well-trained to guide and facilitate your decision-making process like a registered guidance counselor like me. So, if an RGC is not available in your school, you may consider getting the insights of your trusted teacher, parents, or adults. So, napakarami ng taong pwede nating lapitan kung tayo man ay nagdududa o hindi sigurado sa ating mga desisyon. So, remember na ang mga desisyon natin ay syempre, tayo din naman ang makikinabang sa bandang huli. Tayo din naman ang haharap sa consequences ng ating mga magiging desisyon. Now, in order for you to make a better decision or to choose the best decision, you have to consider also asking a piece of advice or asking the opinion of your parents, of the trusted adults in your surroundings. Okay, so napaka-importante na makuha din natin ang insights nila. Although, of course, the final decision will always be yours, especially sa mga edad nyong ganyan. Isa na ito sa mga magiging challenge sa inyo kung paano kayo gagawa ng isang magandang decision. Okay. Now, under You Can Do It, suggested time allotment is 25 minutes. What you're going to do is you're just going to copy the template on a short one paper and list your alternative course of action on the following situation. So here's the table. The title is Looking Into My Decision. So you can see there three columns. In the first column, you can see there situation and numbers. And the second column, what is your decision and what are the factors that lead you to this decision. So maaari na pagpilian natin yung mga factors na nabanggit. Since nabanggit dito, meron tayong lima. The environment, experiences, personal characteristics, facts or data, and motivation. So, yun ang maaari nating ilagay dito. Or kung meron kayong, meron pa kayong naiisip na ibang dahilan kung bakit napunta kayo sa decision na yun. So, in number one situation, a group of learners invited you to join a virtual organization and encouraged you to meet new friends. Okay? To become a member, you need to follow certain rules. Now, ano ang magiging decision mo? Okay? And sa tingin mo, ano kaya ang factor or dahilan, maaring dahilan kung bakit ikaw ay nakapag-desisyon ng ganun? Okay? So, for number one situation, you are going to decide if you're going to join the virtual organization or not. Okay, and number two, your parents told you that they may not be able to support your schooling this year because of financial matters. So, they ask if you can stop attending school. Now, what will be your decision? Are you going to stop or find ways in order for you to continue your studies? And ano kaya sa tingin mo yung factor na nag-lead sa'yo para sa decision na yun? And number three, your cousin asked you to tell a lie to her parents that they have a school event to sneak going with her boyfriend for a date. Nako, ginawa kang sinungaling ng iyong pinsan para sabihin sa nanay niya na siya ay merong dadaluhan na school event. Yun pala ay siya ay makikipag-date lamang sa kanyang boyfriend. Now, what are you going to do? And ano kaya sa tingin mo yung factor that leads you to make that particular decision? And number four, your family is experiencing financial crisis and lost a sustainable livelihood. Okay, and there's an invitation from a friend to try online selling. Okay, so what are you going to do? So are you going to try online selling? So you write there your answer. And of course, the factor that leads you to make that decision. And number five, it's your birthday and your friends would like you to throw a party despite the strict quarantine protocol in your community. Okay, so ano ang gagawin mo? Now, under what I have learned, suggested time allotment is 15 minutes and the title is Dear Anton. Nandito na naman si Anton. We're going to go back to the story of Anton in Let's Try This. Now, if you have the power to travel back in time and help him out in choosing for the best school and course to take in college, what advice will you give him? Okay, imagine ninyo na may kakayahan kayo na mag-travel back. Okay, so imagine nyo na lang na tayo ay merong isang time machine o na tayo ay makakapag-travel pabalik sa panahon ni Anton kung saan siya ay pipili ng pinaka-best na paaralan or best school and course para sa kanya sa kolehiyo. Now, ano ang ibibigay mo sa kanya? Payo. Okay, so you write your answer in a letter format on a piece of paper. Of course, gagawa daw tayo ng isang letter para kay Anton, para sa mga magiging advice mo sa kanya. Now, under share your thoughts and feelings, suggested time allotment is 20 minutes. Ang gagawin po natin is on your answer sheet, write your personal experiences depicting right or wrong decisions you made during this pandemic. Okay, isusulat natin yung ating mga personal experiences na kung saan ikaw ay gumawa ng tama at maling desisyon ngayong pandemic. And of course, number two, cite the reasons why you did such acts and how you resolved that issue. Okay, ano kaya sa tingin mo yung mga reason bakit nagawa mo yun? At ano ang ginawa mo para ma-resolve or maayos ang issue na yun? Okay, so we are done. Okay, so we are done with our module 3. Congratulations, my dear grade 12 students, for finishing this module. So we had a very nice discussion today. So napakaganda din ng topic because we are talking about decision making. Now, decision making skill is a very important skill that we have to have as a person. Okay? Napakarami ng mga desisyon na gagawin natin sa buhay natin, kaya nararapat lamang na alam natin kung paano tayo gagawa ng desisyon. At your early age, dapat you already know how to consider a lot of factors in making your decision. So, napaka-importante na alam natin ang mga kailangan i-consider pag tayo ay gagawa ng desisyon. Remember that don't only consider one thing, but we consider a lot of things in making a decision. So, sometimes, you will really face a very difficult situation wherein isang malaking decision ang gagawin mo. But if you already have this decision-making skill, now you will no longer have any difficulty in making such decision. Although, possible na mahirapan ka, but then will arrive in a wise decision, ika nga, na makakagawa ka ng tamang decision para sa'yo. Now, for me naman, once we decide on a particular thing, we have to face the consequence of our action. Now, in order for us to avoid mistakes also, maiwasan ang mga maling desisyon sa buhay, kailangan natin na, sabi ko nga, ulitin ko, pag-isipan, gumawa ng paraan, i-consider ang lahat ng bagay para makagawa tayo ng tama at hindi tayo magsisi sa bandang huli. And remember, di ba, meron tayong isang famous na kasabihan, ang pagsisisi ay laging nasa huli. Okay, so para ma-avoid or in order for us to avoid regrets, okay, in order for us to avoid as much as possible yung mga failures ng decision making, kailangan natin na maging wise, kailangan natin mas patatagin, mas linangin ang ating decision-making skill. It's now time for you to decide kung meron ka mang bagay na hindi mapag-desisyonan ngayon, panahon na para ikaw ay mag-desisyon. Okay, so that would be all for now, my dear grade 12 students. Again, thank you so much for watching my video. Ayan, so tapos na tayo ng ating module 3 and hopefully next week makapag-upload na tayo ng ating module 4. So again, kung meron tayong mga katanungan, comments or suggestions, maaari nyo itong ilagay sa ating comment box or you can also send me your email. So again, ilalagay ko ito sa ating description box. And please do not forget also to subscribe to this channel, Your Guidance Counselor, and please click the notification bell para maging updated kayo sa mga i-upload kong videos. Now again, this is Montere Buena, Your Guidance Counselor, saying bye for now and see you on our next one.